Hello everyone, welcome to our channel Masters in Chemistry. Today we would like to discuss about the different varying properties of organic compounds. And before going to the different varying properties, I will tell you what is meant by acid and what is meant by base. Acid and the base are classified based on three main theories. I will tell you. The first main theory is Arrhenius. The first main theory is Arrhenius acid-base theory. Let me ask you the question, right? What is meant by Arrhenius acid-base theory? According to Arrhenius acid-base theory, proton donor is an acid. Proton donor is known to be acid. What is meant by proton donor? I will give you an example. I am taking HCl. HCl which gives rise to H+ Cl-. According to the Arrhenius acid-base theory, proton donor is known to be an acid. H+ donor is known to be acid. And the donation of proton should be take place under the aqueous condition. You see here. There are the different theories explaining basic and the basic nature. The first basic theory, I'm explaining the first theory, which is Arrhenius acid-base theory. Then, what is known to be an acid? According to Arrhenius acid-base theory, proton donor is an acid. H+ donor, under the aqueous condition, is known to be acid. Then what is meant by a base? According to Arrhenius acid-base theory, under the aqueous condition, OH- donor is known to be base. OH- donor. When we are taking sodium hydroxide gives rise to Na++ OH-. Now I am writing OH- donor. OH- donor, I'm saying as a base. H+ donor is an acid and OH- donor is a base. Right. Now this is the first theory. Let me tell you the second theory. The second theory I'm explaining, Brønsted-Lowry theory. I will tell you what is meant by Brønsted-Lowry theory. According to the Brønsted-Lowry theory, now when we are discussing about the second concept of acid-base theory, again it explains that proton donor is an acid and OH- donor is a base, or H+ acceptor is a base. H+ donor is an acid and H+ acceptor is a base. I'll tell you. H+ donor, then we are taking the H+ donor. H+ donor is known to be an acid, and the same the H+ acceptor, I'm repeating, H+ acceptor is known to be base. Now it is the second concept. Now coming to the third concept of acid base theory, I'm explaining here. According to the third concept of acid-base theory, when we are discussing, see, H+ donor is an acid and H+ acceptor is a base, according to Brønsted-Lowry theory. Then, according to the third theory of acid-base, I will tell you, the third theory of acid-base is Lewis acid-base theory. What is meant by the Lewis acid-base theory? According to the Lewis acid-base theory, okay, electron pair acceptor, I'm repeating, electron pair acceptor is known to be acid. And according to the Lewis acid-base theory, electron pair donor, I'm repeating, electron pair donor is known to be 10. Now, can we have an example? According to the Lewis acid base theory, Lewis acid base theory is an ideal. I'm repeating. When we are discussing the Lewis acid base theory, is an ideal theory when we are discussing about acid and as well as base. See, according to the Lewis acid base theory, electron deficient is known to be acid, and electron rich species.
Electron rich species is known to be acid. You can say
electrophile, electron deficient, electrophile. They can known to be an acid, and nucleophile. Nucleophiles are known to be base. I will ask you a question. What is the difference between electrophile and nucleophile? Electrophiles are electron deficient. I'm saying as they are known to be that electron loving group. I'm repeating. Example. Electron loving groups are known to be electrophile. The best example here I'm taking H plus. H plus is electron deficient. It accepts electron pair. It accepts electron pair from OH minus. Then it can able to form H plus plus OH minus. H plus plus OH minus gives rise to H2O. Then electron pair acceptor, I'm repeating, electron pair acceptor is known to be Lewis acid. Now they are electron deficient. It is known to be the electron deficient. Then what is meant by Lewis base? Lewis base are nucleophiles, I'm repeating. Lewis base are known to be nucleophiles. The best example I'm taking OH minus, and this OH minus can able to donate electron pair. Electron pair donor is known to be base. Okay, I'm repeating again. What is known to be that Lewis base? Lewis base is nothing but electron pair donor. Electron pair donor is known to be Lewis base. Now, can we have some examples of Lewis acids and bases? Okay. Now we will have some examples of Lewis acids and bases. Just I would like to write here. H plus, electron deficient, Lewis acid. Okay. Just like that. I'm taking AlCl3, Lewis acid. BCl3, Lewis acid. BF3, Lewis acid. BR3, Lewis acid. Okay, now I'm taking here H plus is Lewis acid, AlCl3 Lewis acid, BCl3 Lewis acid, BF3 Lewis acid, and Bi3 is also known to be Lewis acid. Right, now here we're taking these examples. The first example, I'm taking aluminum trichloride, AlCl3. What is the central atom here? Is aluminum. What is the central atom here? Is aluminum. Now, this aluminium is electron deficient. I'm repeating. The aluminium which is known to be the electron deficient. Now, how we can take it as electron deficient? How we can say electron deficient? We can say aluminium is electron deficient based on outer electronic configuration. Based on that outer electronic configuration, the central atom aluminium surrounded by the 3 chlorine atom, and aluminium is known to be electron deficient. So, AlCl3 is a Lewis acid. Like BCl3 is a Lewis acid, BF3 is a Lewis acid, BBr3 Lewis acid, Bi3 Lewis acid. Now they are known to be the Lewis acids. Now these examples, what we can take it as, and all these examples here I'm taking, and all these examples are known to be the Lewis acids. Okay. Now I'll ask you a question, what is meant by Lewis acid? And here I'm writing. When we're discussing the Lewis base, and here I'm writing what is known to be the Lewis base. Lewis base can able to donate electron pair. OH minus is a Lewis base. And ammonia, where the nitrogen containing lone pair is a neutral ligand, I'm saying, which containing electron species, it is also known to be Lewis base. Like any of the species that may containing negative charge or electrophile. For suppose I'm taking H2O. Now this oxygen containing 2 lone pairs, and it is also known to be the Lewis base. I'm taking Cl minus Lewis base, and Br minus Lewis pair. So I'm taking F minus, it acts as a Lewis pair. I'm taking I minus, it is known to be that Lewis pair. Okay? Like that, when we are taking any of the spaces, for suppose I'm taking phenoxide ion, just like a rubber matter system which containing oxygen with a negative charge, it can derive the electrons very easily. Okay? And it is also known to be Lewis pair. Now, so we have the two classifications of acids and bases based on three theories. The first one is Lewis acid. The first one is Arrhenius acid base theory. Number two, Brownstad acid base theory. Number three, Lewis acid base theory. Okay? Okay, I will give you the recap of three concepts step by step. The first concept what we have discussed here, Arrhenius acid base theory. What is Arrhenius acid base theory? When we are discussing about Arrhenius acid base theory, proton donor is an acid. You see here, H plus donor is an acid. Okay, and OH minus donor is a base. Both are identified under the aqueous condition. Under the aqueous condition, H plus donor is an acid. Under the aqueous condition, the OH minus donor is a base. Like this. What is the second theory of acid base theory? According to the Brownstad-Lowry acid base theory, proton donor is a base. For it is proton donor is an acid and the proton acceptor is a base. H plus donor is an acid, H plus acceptor is a base. Next, the final conclusion for the acid base theory, it is very, very important what we are discussing right now, which is Lewis acid base theory. Based on that, Lewis acid base theory, just we are discussing here. Based on the Lewis acid base theory, electron pair acceptor is known to be acid. Electron pair donor is known to be base. Electrophile is known to be acid. Nucleophile is known to be base. What is electrophile? Electron loving group is known to be electrophile. What is nucleophile? Nucleus loving group. What is the charge of the nucleus? Positive charge. Nucleus loving group is known to be nucleophile. What is the charge of electrophile? Is a positive. What is the charge of the nucleophile? Is a negative. The charge of the electrophile is positive and the charge of the nucleophile is negative. Next one. Now can we have an example of Lewis acids and bases? And here we can have an example of Lewis acids and bases. You see this? Lewis acids are electron deficient. Best example, H plus AlCl3. BCl3, BF3, Bn3. In all these atoms, what is the central atom here? The central atom is hydrogen, sorry please. Central atom is aluminium. The central atom is boron. The central atom is boron. The central atom is boron. Okay, aluminium, boron, gallium, indium. In this group, they are known to be electron deficient. When we are taking in the periodic table, in the periodic table of aluminium, boron, right, they are known to be electron deficient. They can accept electrons. Electron pair acceptor, what we are saying is the Lewis acid. Electron pair acceptor is known to be Lewis acid. Now coming to the next classification, the next conclusion, just to have discussed what is going to be Lewis base. Lewis base is known to be electron rich species. Any species which containing rich electron species or it containing negative charge. If it containing electron pair, ammonia which containing an electron pair, nitrogen containing the electron pair, Lewis pair. H2O, the oxygen containing the two lone pair, it is known to be Lewis base. Cl minus, Br minus, F minus, I minus, they're containing negative charge, they are known to be the Lewis bases. And OH minus, where the oxygen containing the negative charge, it is known to be the Lewis bases. Right? Lewis acids and Lewis bases. This is the first concept of acid-base theory. I'm repeating again. The first basic principle of acid-base theory is number one, Arrhenius acid-base theory. Number two, Brownstad-Lowry acid-base theory. Number three, Lewis acid-base theory. Now we can apply acid-base theory to, we can apply the acid-base theory to organic compounds. Now we can apply for organic compound. What is an organic compound? Just a previous class we have discussed. An organic compound must contain carbon, hydrogen. Now I am taking aromatic system. For aromatic system, the best example is benzene. All benzenoid compounds are aromatic. Now I'm containing benzene containing carboxylic acid. The name of the compound, here I'm taking benzoic acid. I'm repeating. The name of the compound, here I'm taking benzoic acid. I'll ask a question, right? Is it acid or base? The first thing we should write elaborately, what is known to be benzoic acid. Benzoic acid can be written like this, COO minus and H plus. Okay, then H plus donor, according to arginine acid base theory and the Bronsted acid base theory, H plus donor is an acid. So what we are getting here, you see that, just what we are getting here, we are getting benzoic acid gives rise to benzoyl. I'm writing like this, COO O minus and removal of H plus takes place. H plus donor is an acid. Okay. So I'm saying benzoic acid. Just I'm saying benzoic acid is an acid. Okay. Like this. So I'll take another example. I'm taking the second example. The second example I'm taking as a phenol. What is this? Phenol. Now I'll ask the question. Is it acid or base? Okay. Again, the phenol containing oxygen and hydrogen, which is more electronegative. Oxygen is more electronegative, negative charge. Hydrogen less electronegative, positive charge. Then what happened? Just I'm writing its resonance structure. When we are writing the resonance structure, phenol gives rise to phenoxyanion. Phenol gives rise to phenoxyanion and it donates H plus. And again, H plus donor is an acid. I'm repeating. H plus donor is an acid or this? H plus donor is an acid. Okay. Benzoic acid. Benzoic acid having which character? Acidic character. Phenol having which character? Acidic character. Benzoic acid is acid and phenol is acid. I'm repeating. Benzoic acid which is having acidic property. I'm repeating. Benzoic acid having acidic property and the phenol having. Phenol is also having acidic property. Phenol which is also having acidic property. Benzoic acid having acidic property and the phenol having acidic property. Right? Next one. Now, I will tell you what is meant by base. And here I am taking the best example, an aromatic system. And this aromatic system containing NH2. NH2 group, what we are saying is amine. The name of an aromatic compound is aniline. I am repeating. What is this? Aniline. It is an amine group. Simply I am saying it is a primary amine. It is known to be primary amine. Now let me ask the question, is it acid or base? I will tell you it is acid or base. Just I would like to write its resonance structure. Then we are taking aniline. Nitrogen valence is equal to 3. Here hydrogen. Hydrogen. Now this nitrogen containing lone pair. This nitrogen containing lone pair. And the lone pair donor is a base. I'm repeating. Lone pair donor is a base. You see this. This lone pair is donated to ring system. This lone pair is donated to ring system. Okay. Now, so is it acid or base? So I'm saying it is known to be base. According to which concept? Lewis acid base theory. According to Lewis acid base theory, electron pair donor, I'm repeating. According to Lewis acid base theory, electron pair donor is base. So I am taking aluminium is going to be base. Okay, right. Like this, we can have an example, secondary and tertiary amines, and they are also known to be bases. And here I am taking nitrogen. One of the hydrogen replaces with methyl and hydrogen. And here I am taking aromatic ring system. This is nitrogen, and another hydrogen replaces with the methyl. Then the name of the compound becomes, one of the hydrogen replaces with the methyl, and the two hydrogens replaces with the methyl. So I am saying this is secondary amine. It is known to be secondary amine, and it is known to be tertiary amine. Secondary amine followed by tertiary amine. You see this. Secondary amine followed by tertiary amine. Right now. Now friends, let me ask you a question, which is more basic. Primary amine, secondary amine, tertiary amine. Now this secondary amine which containing a methyl, which is also donating the electron through plus I effect. Plus I inductive effect. Through plus I effect donating electron. Then what happens? The electron density on the nitrogen increases. Now here, in the tertiary amine, this is NN dimethyl aniline. Can you write the name? Secondary amine, nitrogen containing methyl, N methyl aniline. I'm repeating. The name of the compound is N methyl aniline. Next one. The next compound is N, N dimethyl aniline. I'm repeating. N, N dimethyl aniline. N, N dimethyl aniline. Now see this. Just aniline is a base. N methyl dimethylaniline is a base. N methyl aniline is a base. NN dimethyl aniline is a base. Which is more basic? NN dimethyl aniline containing the 2 plus I groups. NN dimethyl aniline containing the 2 plus I groups. When electron donating group present on the basic group, when electron donating group is attached to base, the basic nature increases. Why? Because electron density increases. When the electron density increases, electron donating ability increases. Simple. More is the electron density, the more is the basic nature. Can you write like this? Basic nature, I'm repeating. Then we are discussing about the basic nature. Basic nature is directly proportional to electron density. I'm repeating. When the basic nature increases, simply the electron density increases. Or when the electron density increases, when the electron density increases, then the basic nature increases. If there any basic group containing electron donating, then what happens? Basic nature increases. I'm repeating. At this point is very, very important. The basic nature influenced by electron donating group. If electron donating group, I'm repeating. If electron donating group is present on basic functional. I'm repeating. Basic functional group. Electron donating group is present on the basic functional group. Then what happens? The basic nature increases. Then it is known to be strong base. Okay? Then it is known to be strong base. What is SP? Strong base. Now which is strong base here? And here I am taking structure 1, primary amine, structure 2, secondary amine, and structure 3, tertiary amine. Which is strong base? Primary amine, secondary amine, tertiary amine. Tertiary amine is a strong base when compared with the primary, when compared with the secondary. Can you write the order? Tertiary amine having the strong basic nature when compared with the secondary amine, when compared with the primary amine, which is more basic, right? Tertiary amine is more basic. I'm repeating. Tertiary amine is more basic than secondary amine, than primary amine. The tertiary amine is going to be more basic than primary. Tertiary is more basic than secondary, and as well as primary. No friends, I'll ask you a question, right? Just I will give you some compounds. You should identify which is more basic, which is less basic. I'll give you some compounds. You should identify which is more acidic and which is less acidic. You see here, the first compound I'm here giving, benzoic acid. The next one I'm giving, this is the meta position, metanitrobenzoic acid. The next one I'm giving, it is phenol, and this phenol containing NH2, para-aminophenol. Can you write the names of the compound? You see here, it is known to be benzoic acid. Now, what is this? Metanitro. Ortho position, meta position, para position. Metanitro benzoic acid. Next one. It is ortho position. Now it is meta position and it is para position. Para, NH2 is nothing but amine, amino, phenol. Para amino phenol. Now, when we are discussing acidic nature, electron withdrawing group, I'm repeating. If electron withdrawing group is present in acid, electron withdrawing group increases acidic nature. I'm repeating. Electron withdrawing group increases acidic nature. Now, where we can have the electron withdrawing group in this structure? NO2 is electron withdrawing. NH2 is electron donating. I'm repeating. If any acidic functional group containing electron donating group, if it containing electron donating group, then what happens? If it containing electron donating group, then the acidic nature decreases. If it containing electron donating group, the acidic nature decreases. If it containing electron withdrawing group, the acidic nature increases. If it containing electron withdrawing group, what happens? Acidic nature increases. If it containing electron withdrawing group, what happens? Acidic nature decreases. Now taking, it is A, it is known to be B, and it is known to be C. Can you write the order of acidity? The order of acidic nature can be written like this. B containing electron withdrawing group, B is greater than, next, benzoic acid. A is greater than, B greater than, A greater than, C. I'm repeating. B greater than, A greater than, C. Now simple. When we are discussing about any of organic compound, any of aromatic system, any of aromatic system, when we are discussing, if any aromatic system containing acidic functional group, if it is known to be an acid, if it is known to be acid, right? Acid containing electron withdrawing group increases acidic nature. If the acid containing electron donating group decreases acidic nature. You see here, phenol is known to be acidic nature. Now this phenol containing which type of the group? It is electron donating. Then acidic nature decreases. Now, benzoic acid containing NO2 group. What is NO2 group? NO2 is known to be that electron withdrawing group. Electron withdrawing group, what happens? Electron withdrawing group withdraws electron density, then acidic nature increases. If electron withdrawing group is present, acidic nature increases. If electron donating group is present, acidic nature decreases. Right? I'm repeating. If electron withdrawing group is present, acidic nature increases. If electron donating group is present, acidic nature decreases. So, the acidic nature order of benzoic acid, metanitrobenzoic acid, and the para-imino-phenol should be like this. Metanitrobenzoic acid greater than, benzoic acid greater than, para-imino-phenol. We will have more examples like this. Okay. Just I would like to take an aromatic ring system. And this aromatic ring system containing phenol. Just I would like to keep an electron with the drawing group. Para nitrophenol. NO2. Then what happens? You see this. Electron with the drawing group donating. It is electron with the drawing group. Less acidic or more acidic? Simple. When electron withdrawing group is present, acidic nature decreases, which is less acidic. Okay, and it is known to be less acidic. Like this. I'm taking another molecule here. Trinitrobenzoic acid. It's a benzoic acid. Okay, I'm keeping nitrogen NO2 group here. I'm keeping NO2 group here. I'm keeping NO2 group here. If any group is present like this, then what happens? Electron withdrawing, electron withdrawing, electron withdrawing. And this group containing more acidic nature. As simply I'm saying as high acidic nature. Okay. Now, can we apply the same concept to aliphatic system? We will see. We can apply the same concepts to aliphatic systems. Okay, I will tell you the aliphatic system. CH3 NH2 primary amine. CH3 nitrogen. CH3 hydrogen. Next, CH3 nitrogen. CH3 and CH3. Now, which is more basic? Nitrogen containing lone pair donor. Lone pair donor is always known to be base. Right. Now, it is primary, it is secondary, it is tertiary. It is primary amine, it is secondary amine, and it is known to be that tertiary amine. I will ask the question, which is more basic? Now, when we are discussing which is more basic and which is less basic, simple. Just I would like to discuss which is more basic and which is less basic. Simple concept, right? Primary amine, okay, and the secondary amine containing the 2+ side groups, and tertiary amine containing the 3+ side groups. What is a plus side group? Plus side group is electron donating group. Plus side group is electron donating group. Simple. Plus side group is electron donating. 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 How many electron donating groups take place in primary amine? Primary amine containing 1 electron donating group. Okay. Secondary amine containing 2 electron donating groups. And tertiary amine containing 3 electron groups. Now I can write the basic order. Tertiary amine, NN dimethyl amine is greater than secondary amine. Secondary amine is greater than primary. I'm repeating. Tertiary greater than, secondary greater than primary. Now it is about aliphatic amine. Like this, you can take any of the aliphatic compounds. It may contain a lone pair. Okay, any of aliphatic system, it may contain lone pair. Lone pair donor is known to be base. Lone pair donor is a base. Now see this. Just I would like to apply the same concept to acidic nature. Just I would like to apply the same concept to acidic nature. Okay, Can I write here CH3 COOH, cystic acid. And here I'm replacing one of the hydrogen with the Cl, chloroacetic acid. Then dichloroacetic acid. And here I'm replacing three hydrogen with three chlorine atom, trichloroacetic acid. Now, and all these belonging to acids, right? These all belonging to acids. You see here, CH3COOH, which is acetic acid. Okay, then what is this? Chloroacetic acid. Then what is this? Dichloroacetic acid. And what is this? Trichloroacetic acid. Okay, 1, 1. Dichloroacetic acid. What is this? 1, 1. Trichloroacetic acid. Friend, just to ask the question, right? Which is more acidic? The chlorine, which has withdraws electron density. What is this? Now this group is electron withdrawing group, donating or withdrawing. It is electron withdrawing. Okay, I'm keeping here in the structure. This is A, and it is B, and it is C, and it is D. Just I will ask the question: which is containing more number of electron withdrawing group? Trichloroacetic acid containing. I'm repeating. Trichloroacetic acid containing three chlorine atoms. High number of electron withdrawing group. The more number of electron withdrawing group. When the number of electron withdrawing groups increases, acidic nature increases. So when you are discussing about acidic nature, B greater than C, C greater than B, and the B greater than A. And here the correct order of acidic nature comes here. Trichloroacetic acid, then trichloroacetic acid, then chloroacetic acid, then A. Simple. When you are taking aliphatic system, I'm repeating. When you are taking aliphatic system, then B greater than C greater than B greater than A. Trichloroacetic acid greater than dichloroacetic acid greater than chloroacetic acid greater than acetic acid. Okay. Now in all this classification, what we have discussed is acidic strength is increased by electron withdrawing group. Acidic strength is decreased by electron donating group. I'm repeating. Acidic strength is decreased by electron donating group. For suppose I'm keeping methyl here instead of CH3, then what happens? It becomes less acidic. For suppose I'm keeping two methyl groups here. For suppose I'm keeping three methyl groups here, what happens? And these methyl groups are electron donating. Methyl groups are electron donating. Then chlorine groups are electron withdrawing. Cl participating in minus I effect. Cl participating in minus I effect. Minus I effect, electron withdrawing. Minus I is always electron withdrawing. Plus I is always electron donating. If these groups are replaced by CH3 plus I group, then what happens? Acidic nature decreases. So we can conclude here. We can write like this: plus I group, plus M group, and both decreases acidic nature. Minus I group and minus M group, and both increases acidic nature. Okay. Now we can write the same conclusion for the basic compound. We can write the same conclusion for the basic compound reverse. Plus I plus M, which is directly proportional to more basic nature. The basic nature increases. minus psi minus m, what happens? The basic nature decreases. Just vice versa. Just keep in your mind these two very, very important points. When you are keeping in your mind these two very, very important points, that is, plus A inductor effect, plus the remainder effect increases its big nature. Minus I inductor effect, minus mesomeric effect. Plus inductor effect, plus mesomeric, acidic nature decreases. Why? Because they are electron donating. Minus I, minus M. Minus I inductor effect, minus M mesomeric effect. Then, they are increasing acidic nature. They are known to be electron withdrawing. Like this. Plus I, plus M. Increasing basic nature. Electron donating. Minus I, minus M. Decreases basic nature. Electron withdrawing. Friends, could I have discussed what is meant by acid and bases? I will give you a small recap of today's class. The first concept we have discussed, Argyris acid base theory, Brownshield-Lowry acid base theory, Lewis acid base theory. I'm repeating. Proton donor is an acid, OH minus donor is a base, and the aqueous condition, it is known to be the Arrhenius acid base theory. Number two, Brownshield-Lowry acid base theory. According to Brownshield-Lowry acid base theory, H plus donor is an acid, H plus acceptor is a base. Then, very, very important theory of acid bases. Just now we have discussed Lewis acid base theory. Electron pair acceptor is an acid, electron pair donor is a base. Electrophile is an acid, nucleophile is a base. Electrophile is an acid and the nucleophile is going to be base. Now, based on this, in the beginning we have discussed there are the two classification of Lewis acids and bases. You see this. Lewis acids are electron deficient, H plus, AlCl3, BCl3, BF3, Bi3. In AlCl3, BCl3, BF3, Bi3, the central atom aluminium, the central atom boron, when we are taking electronic configuration, they can accept electrons. Electron acceptor is a Lewis acid. Now, what is a Lewis base here? When we are discussing Lewis base, OH minus, NH3, H2O, Cl minus, Br minus, F minus, I minus, and phenoxidium. In all these conditions, what we are having? Negative charge as a lone pair. Okay, H2O is neutral, it doesn't contain any charge, but dampen containing two lone pairs. NH3 nitrogen containing one lone pair, OH minus, Cl minus, Br minus, F minus, I minus, okay? They're having, they're rich in their negative charge. They're rich in the negative charge, they are known to be Lewis bases. Lewis base containing high electron density. The high electron density, they are known to be Lewis bases. Then, electron deficient, they are known to be Lewis acids. Now, this is the first concept just now we have discussed. Arrhenius acid base theory, Brownshield-Lowry acid base theory, and Lewis base. In the continuation, we have discussed benzoic acid is an acid, phenol is an acid. Okay, benzoic acid containing H plus donor is an acid, and phenol containing OH, H plus donor is known to be an acid. Phenoxide ion plus H plus, benzoate ion plus H plus donor is an acid. Benzoic acid having acidic nature. And the phenol having acidic nature. Just now we have discussed what is when they are base. Now we are taking the example as aniline. Aniline is known to be primary amine. Aniline containing nitrogen and this nitrogen containing lone pair NH2 followed by C6H5. Benzene containing NH2. It is known to be aniline. It is known to be primary amine. Lone pair donor is a base. Then secondary amine. N-methyl-aniline. Now, this methyl group is electron donating and it is also known to be a base. Next one, tertiary amine, N-N-dimethyl-aniline. N-N-dimethyl-aniline. Again, this nitrogen containing lone pair, methyl participating in plus I effect, CH3 participating in plus I effect, N-N-dimethylamine is also known to be a base. Okay? Now, when we are comparing the basic nature directly proportional to electron density. That means plus 5 plus 10 groups increases basic nature. Now here aniline containing two hydrogens and here secondary amine. One of the hydrogen replaces by methyl. Tertiary amine, two hydrogens replaces by the two methyl, which is more basic. Tertiary amine greater than secondary amine greater than primary amine. Just I would like to conclude my topic right here at this point. Very very important. Plus sign plus m, acidic nature decreases. Minus sign minus m, acidic nature increases. Plus sign plus m, basic nature increases. Minus sign minus m, basic nature decreases. Here we can have an example of acetic acid, chloroacetic acid, dichloroacetic acid, trichloroacetic acid, three chlorine atoms, three alphas drawing it. Trichloroacetic acid is more acidic than dichloroacetic acid, then chloroacetic acid, then acetic acid, like this. Methylamine, NN dimethylamine, NNN trimethylamine, primary amine, secondary amine, tertiary amine. 3 plus I groups, 2 plus I groups, 1 plus I group increasing basic nature. Tertiary greater than, secondary greater than, primary. I'm repeating. Plus sign, plus sum. Acidic nature decreases. Minus sign, minus sum. Acidic nature increases. Plus sign, plus sum. Basic nature increases. Minus sign, minus sum. Basic nature decreases. Based on all these basic concepts, right, we should work on organic compounds, aromatic system, aliphatic system of acids and bases, right? I think this concept is very valuable in solving IIT, NEET, and as well as MCET objectives, right? Thank you very much. Thanks for listening. We will see the continuation class in the coming videos. Thank you.